Hello, one and all present here. This is Amit Kumar Singh, and welcome to my class on time and work. And in this class, I'll discuss a previous year question papers of civil service aptitude exam. And we try to cover like what are can be the important questions when you talk about this topic called time and work in regard of civil service aptitude exam. So basically, when we talk about time and work, in the case of time and work, we solve the questions based on inverse proportion. Like if there's a person called A and A can do the work in 8 days, and B, there's a person called B and B can do the work in B days. So what we'll do, so if the question is that if A and B will work together, then when the work will get over? So in this case, the work will get over in AB by A plus B days. So you need to understand like when A is alone doing the work, A can complete the work in 8 days. And if definitely if there's other person who will come to help A, definitely the work will be done in lesser number of days. So when we work on time and work, like if A, there's a person called A and A can do the work in 8 days. So I'll say in one day, the portion of work done by A, I'll discuss like in the same manner that in one day the portion of work done by A, so the portion of work done by A, that will be 1 by A part. Okay. So then I'll say in one day the portion of work done by B in one day, the portion of work done by B in one day, the portion of work done by B. So in one day, the portion of work done by B. So when I talk about B, so that would be 1 by B bar. So when I talk about A and B, so if A and B are working together, if A and B are working together, then the amount of work done in one day, that will be equal to 1 by A plus 1 by B. So you just need to solve this 1 by A plus 1 by B. So you take LCM. So in one day, how much work will be done? In one day, A plus B by AB work is done. So then the complete work will be done in. Then the complete work will be done in AB by A plus B days. There are a lot of shortcut ways of doing the problem whenever you try to solve the problem based on time and work. So when we talk about time and work, so if there's a person called A who can do the work in 8 days, so we assume that every day the A will do 1 by A part of work. So it's not like one day the A will do more work, the other day the A would do less work. We will not work in all such cases. We'll do step by step. So if A can do the work in 8 days, so in one day A can do 1 by A part of work. If B can do the work in B days, then in one day B would do 1 by B part of work. So when they are working together, then they will do 1 by A plus 1 by B. So that is a way how you need to solve the problem. So this way, if you solve the problem, many of you won't like this way. This will be the cumbersome work which we learned in schooling. So these are the steps what we have learned in the schooling to solve the problem. So other way of solving the problem is like, you can see this question, it came in 2015. So there are two pipes are there which can independently fill that tank in 20 minute and 30 minute respectively. If both the pipes are open simultaneously, then how much time they will take to do the work? So you can see this. So if A is doing the work, A can do the work in 20 minutes. So then if B is doing the work, B can do the work in 30 minutes. So what you do, define work. Define work as LCM of 20 and 30. 20 and 30, LCM is 60. So let the work is 60 units. So then in one day, A would do 3 units of work. And in one day, the B would do 2 units of work. So when A and B are working together, in one day, A and B would do how much unit of work? They will do 5 unit of work. So they do 5 unit of work in one day. So A and B A and B in one day do 5 units of work. They do 5 units of work in one day. So 60 units of work they will do in how many days? They will do in 12 days. That much, that is your answer. Or here they're talking in minutes. So you can talk in minutes. So here instead of day, you can write minute. So in A and B, they do 5 units of work in 1 minute. So 60 units of work they will do in how many minutes? 60 units of work they will do in how many minutes? So 60 units of work they will do in 12 minutes. That is the one way. The other way of solving is if you apply like this formula. So 20 into 30 divide by 20 plus 30. So you do this is 600 divide by 50. You do this, you will get 12. That is the one way. Or you can do step by step. So A can do the work in 20 minutes. So in 1 minute, how much part of work A do? 1 by 20 part. Then B can do the work in 30 minutes. So in 1 minute, how much work B can do? B can do 1 by 30 part. So if A and B are working together, then in 1 minute, A and B can do how much unit of work? That would be 1 by 20 plus 1 by 30. That will be, if you take LCM, you get 60. So this is 5 by 60 or 1 by 12 part. So 1 by 12 part of work A and B, they do together in 1 minute. So the total work will be done in 12 minutes. So the total work will be done in 12 minutes. So there are a lot of ways are there to solve the problem. It doesn't matter. Whichever way you do, you can get the answer very easily. I prefer this way of solving because I believe this way when I solve, I can do it very fast. Okay. Now you can see for question number two, 15 men. So you can see for question number two. So you can see for question number two that if 15 men can prepare, 12 twice working 5 hours a day in 16 days, then in how many days can 10 men can prepare 15 twice working 8 hours a day? So here you can use the formula. So we work on the formula that here work is equal to men into days. So here we are not studying physics, that where we define work in the term of joule. Okay, so here I'm defining work in the term of men into days. Men doesn't mean that I'm gender biased. Men means any individual who is doing the work. It doesn't matter X or Y or Z, whoever is that, a man or woman or children or donkey, that doesn't matter to me. So the individuals who are doing the work and the time what they take to do the work. So that is that way I define the work. So in that way, when we talk about work, so the formula what we follow, that M1 D1 by W1 is equal to M2 D2 by W2. So this is the constant what you can use. So work is equal to men into days. So if work is constant, then men into days would be inversely proportional. So on that basis, you can write M1 D1 by W1 equal to M2 D2 by W2. So 15 men can prepare 12 twice, work is 12 twice day. So means 15 hours a day into 16 days. So 5 hours a day, so the total time they take is 18 hours, and divide by this is equal to how many men. So 10 men can prepare 15 twice working 8 hours a day. So the how many days will they take? So you just need to solve it. So if you're trying to solve, this is 8 2s and this is 6s. Okay, then this is 2s. And this is 5s. This is 2s. This is 2s. So now you can get the day. So your day is equal to how much? That is 15 into 5 in numerator. Then in denominator, 2 into 2. So 15 5s are 75 by 4. 75, 18 4s are 72. 18 3 by 5. 18 3 by 4. That will give you the answer. So the answer is option B. You can solve it very easily. Now you can see the next question. A woman can weave a basket in 6 days, but with the help of daughters, he can do it in 4 days. What time they can do the work together? So you know that I told you that if A can do the work in 8 days and B can do the work in 3 days, when they work together, then they'll complete the work in AB by A plus B days. So this is already I discussed the formula. So already I've discussed this formula with you. So a woman can weave a basket in 6 days. So woman, so the formula would be W into B by W plus D. So when they work together, they complete the work in 4 days. And so woman into daughter divided by woman plus daughter. That give you the answer called 4. Woman in 6 days. So in place of woman, I can write 6 days. So 6 plus D equal to 4. So I just need to solve 6D is equal to 24 plus 4D. So 2D is equal to 24. So D is equal to 12. You need to solve very simple. So if you want to spend time, you can spend time for getting the answer for these kind of problems. If you want to spend time, you have full right to spend time, but that is not required. So that is not required to do this. So women can do, a woman can weave a basket, a woman can weave a basket in 6 days. So in 1 day, how much the woman can weave? The woman can weave 1/6 part, and her daughter can do the work, suppose in B day. So in 1 day, how much the work her daughter can do? 1/D part. So when they are working together, in 1 day, the woman and her daughter can do how much part of work? 1/D plus 1/6. And that is equal to the total number of days they can do the work. They can do the work in 4 days. Means in 1 day, how much work they are doing? They are doing 1/4 part of work. 1/D is equal to 1/4 minus 1/6. The LCM is 12. So you get 1/D equal to 1/12. It means her daughter in 1 day, do 1/12 part of work. So if a daughter in 1 day do 1/12 part of work, so the total work her daughter can do, in 12 days. So you can understand this part. So there are a lot of ways are there to solving the problem. Same problem, I'm telling you different ways. So the woman can do the work in 6 days and her daughter can do the work in D days. So define work as the LCM. Let the work is 6D unit, LCM of 6 and D, 6D unit. So in 1 day, her daughter is doing D unit of work. In one day, woman is doing D unit of work. In 1 day, her daughter is doing 6 unit of work. So in 1 day, when woman and daughter are working together, they are doing D by 6 unit of work. In 1 day, they are doing D plus 6 unit of work. And the total work they are completing in 4 days. Hello, you all can hear me, right? Hello, so 1 minute. There is some internet problem happened. So I'll do it again. I don't know where I missed you people. So suppose the woman can do the work in 6 days. Her daughter can do the work in D days. So define the work as the LCM of 6 and D. Then in 1 day, the woman can do D unit of work. In 1 day, her daughter can do 6 unit of work. So when they are working together in 1 day, they will do D plus 6 unit of work. And total work they'll finish in 4 days. So in 4 days, they will do 4 into 6 plus D unit of work. So this is equal to the total work. So 4 into 6 plus D, that is equal to the total work. Total work is 6D. So I can write 24 plus 4D is equal to 60. So 2D is equal to 24. So D is equal to. So for the same problem, I told you different ways of solving the problem. Just one problem I explained you. I think by 3 ways till now I explained you. 4 ways I explained you to solve the problem. So we did it by the formula. You can do the formula called AB by A plus B. You can do like this way. So if A can do the work in 8 days, B can do the work in B days. So when A and B are working together, they'll complete the work in EB by A plus B days. You can do like this, or you can do manually, or you can solve it by LCM, or the other way you can do with percentage also. Same problem you can do with percentage. So woman can do the work in 6 days. So it means in 1 day, she is doing 1/6 part. 1/6 part means she's doing 16.67% of work. Or daughter, I don't know. So her daughter, I have no idea. So leave it. When they are doing together, woman and daughter, they're completing the work in 4 days. Means in 1 day, how much part they're doing? In 1 day, they're doing together 25% of work. Woman alone is doing 16.67% of work. And woman and daughter is doing the 25% of work. So woman and daughter together, they're doing 25% of work. And woman alone is doing 16.67% of work. So how much percentage of work her daughter is doing? Her daughter is doing 8.33% of work. 8.33% is nothing but 1/12. Those who have basic knowledge and percentage, they know that 8.33% is nothing but 1/12. It means her daughter is completing the work in 12 days. So now you can see, so different ways I explained you to solve the problem. Now you can see this question number 4. Now working together, P and Q can do the work. P and Q can do the work in 6 days. And Q and R can do the work in 10 days. Okay, and P and R can do the work in 5 days. Okay, so imagine P plus Q means A. Suppose there's a person A whose efficiency is the sum of efficiency of P plus Q. A can do the work in 6 days. Q plus R is equal to a person B. Suppose B can do the work in 10 days. And similarly, P plus R is equal to C. So mean the person C can do the work in 5 days. So if they will work together, when the work will get over, so take the LCM of 6, 5 and 10. So the LCM of 6, 5 and 10 would be 30, I guess. The LCM of 6, 5 and 10 will be 30. So 6, 5 and 10 LCM would be 30. So 6, 5, 10. So 2, 3, 5, 5, 5, 3, 1, then 3. So 15 to the 6, 15 to the 30. So let the work is 30 unit. 1 day, how much work the A is doing? 5 unit of work. In 1 day, how much work B is doing? 3 unit of work. In 1 day, how much work C is doing? 6 unit of work. So when A, B, C, they are working together, then in 1 day, how much work they are doing? They are doing 14 unit of work in 1 day. So the 30 unit of work they will do in how many days? A plus B plus C. That would be equal to 30/14. That would be equal to 15/7. So means when A plus B plus C, they are doing the work, so the total work they will do in 15/7 days. But you need to understand, in this problem, there's no A, B and C. In this problem, you have P, Q, R. So means you understand. Now I'm talking about individually. So if you think individually when they're doing the work, now A was double of 2%. B was double of 2% and C was double of 2%. Means they're working as double of the efficiency. So they're completing the work in 15/7 days. So means if I ask you about P, Q and R, so they'll complete the work in how many days? That would be 30/7 days. 30/7 means 42/7 days. You understand, right? Because when you talk about A is equal to, when you talk about A, Here you see, when you talk about A plus B plus C, the efficiency, that is a double of the efficiency of P plus Q plus R. So you understand P plus Q, like to understand the p 2p plus 2q plus 2r, they're doing the work in 15 by 7 days. So p plus q plus r will do the work in 30 by 7 days. They work in inverse proportion. Understand like this. Still, if you have doubt, so see, understand a plus b plus c, they're doing the work in 15 by 7 days. So a plus b plus c is nothing but that is equal to 2p plus 2q plus 2r. They're doing the work in 15 by 7 days. So imagine if I ask you p plus q plus r. Imagine if the number of people will decrease, then you'll take more time. So the p plus q plus r, they'll complete the work in 30 by 7 days. I hope you understood this. If you do not understand, I can solve this question by traditional method. Now, if you do not understand, so that then it would be time consuming. So then it means 1 by p plus 1 by q, that is equal to 1 by 6, then 1 by q plus 1 by r. This is 1 by 6. So 1 by q plus 1 by r is equal to 1 by 10. Then 1 by p plus 1 by r is equal to 1 by 5. Now add them. So if you add them, you will get 2 by p plus 2 by q plus 2 by r is equal to 1 by 6 plus 1 by 10 plus 1 by 5. So you can write, if you take 2 common, so 1 by p plus 1 by q plus 1 by r, that is equal to, this LCM is 30, so 5 plus 3 plus 6, so that is equal to 14 by 30, so that is equal to 7 by 15. So 2 into 1 by p plus 1 by q plus 1 by r is equal to 7 by 15. So 1 by p plus 1 by q plus 1 by r is equal to 7 by 30. Means when p, q and r, they are working together, then in one day they will do this much unit of work. In one day they do 7 by 30 part of work. So p plus q plus r, total work they will complete in 30 by 7 days. 30 by 7 means 4 2 by 7 days. Now you see the next question, question number 5. Now this, the efficiency of Romil is twice that of Sanjay. So efficiency of Romil is twice that of Sanjay. So you suppose if Romil can do the work in 8 days, it means Sanjay can do the same work in 2 8 days. And the efficiency of Romil is twice of the Sanjay. And he can finish the work 4 hours less than the time taken by Sanjay. So means the time taken by Romil, that is the right time taken by Sanjay minus the time taken by Romil is equal to 4 days. Means Romil can finish the work four days less than the Sanjay. So means Sanjay is taking 4 days more than Romil. It means Sanjay is taking the number of days taken by Sanjay. Sanjay is taking 4 more days to Romil to do the work. So the Sanjay is taking 2 R and Romil is taking R. So you can say R is equal to 4. So now question is that if both of them work together, when they'll complete the work. So it means Romil can do the work. It means Romil can do the work in 4 days. If Romil can do the work in 4 days, it means Sanjay can do the same work in 8 days. Now, if they'll work together, let the work is LCM. The LCM of 4 and 8 is 8. So it means in one day, Romil do 2 unit of work. In one day, Sanjay do 1 unit of work. Together, they do 3 unit of work in one day. So in one day, they do 3 unit of work. Together, they will complete the work in 8 by 3 days. So 3 unit of work in one day, so 8 unit of work in 8 by 3 days. Here they're talking in hours, so you can talk in the term of hour. I hope that is okay with you. So whatever the unit of time is there, you can go with that. Fine. I don't think anyone have any doubt on this part. So if you want, so we can discuss in the term. So we can discuss in the term of hour and all. So we can discuss in the term of hour. Romil can do the work in our hour. So the Sanjay can do the same work in 2 hour. And so if they work together, then if they'll work together, then it means they will do 3 units of work in 1 hour. So 2 hour unit of work they will do in how many hours? That would be 2 hours by 3 hours. So when Romil and Sanjay are working together, so they'll complete a work in 2 hours by 3 hours. And then it's given that the time what the Sanjay takes to do the work, that is 4 hours more than the time what the Romil takes to do the work. Now Romil takes our hour and Sanjay takes 2 hours. With that you will get the value of R equal to 4. So if you put that value of R in the equation, you will get the answer as 8/3. Fine. Now going further, you see question number 6. So in a garrison, there is a food for 1,000 soldier for 1 month, and then after 10 days 1,000 more soldiers joined the garrison. This question came in 2013 UPSC exam. So how would the soldier would able to carry out the remaining food? So understand how much is the total food. So if you talk about total food, how much is the total food? Total food is that much that 1,000 soldiers can eat this food for. Your food is that much that 1,000 soldiers can eat that food for 30 days. Okay. So in 10 days, how much food finished in 10 days? How much food they'll finish? So 1,000 soldiers are there in 10 days, how much they will eat? They'll eat 1,000 into 10. So how much food left? Now how much food left? Food left is 1,000 into 20. This much food is left after 10 days. What happens after 10 days? 1,000 more soldiers will join. So now your food is this much. Now this much food is left. But now the number of soldiers has increased by 1,000. So now the total soldier is 2,000. Now these 2,000 soldiers, how many days they will take to complete 1,000 into 20 unit of food? This is what you need to solve. This is Pooja. So you can find the value of D. So the D will be equal to 10 days. So for the remaining food, now 2,000 soldiers are there. They will complete in 10 days. Right. So then you can see the next question. Question number 7. Now you can see the next question. Question number 7. A and B can do a piece of work in 8 and 12 hours. If you give a work to A will do in 8 hours, B will do in 12 hours. Let the work, take the work as the LCM. So the LCM will be 24 units. So let the work is 24 units. Means in 1 hour, A do 3 units of work. In 1 hour, B do 2 units of work. So in 1 hour, A plus B, they will together will do 5 units of work. 1 hour, A and B together, they will do 5 units of work. But in this problem, they are not working together. They are working alternatively. It means in 2 hours, they are working alternatively, means A and B. So in 2 hours, A and B alternatively will finish how much unit of work? they would finish 5 unit of work. Okay, and the total work is 24. So means 20 unit of work will be finished in how many hours? 8 hours. 20 unit of work will be finished in how many hours? 8 hours. So in 8 hours, 20 unit of work is finished. Okay, they are working alternatively. First A, then B. Then 9th hour, who will work? 9th hour, A will work. And A would do how many unit of work? 3 unit of work. So after 9 hour, 23 unit of work is done. Now total work is 24. So how much unit of work is left? 1 unit of work is left. And who will do that work? B will do that work. In one, so you understand that in 1 hour, B do 2 unit of work. So 1 unit of work B would do in 30 minutes. And so the total work, so now 1 unit of work is left. 1 unit of work is left. 1 unit of work is left, which is done by B. You understand, no? Which is done by B on 10th hour. Which is done by B on 10th hour because they're working alternatively. Because they're working alternatively. So in 9 hour, 23 unit of work is done. So on 10th hour, B will do the work. On 10th hour, B will do the work. And how much unit of work B will do? B in 1 hour do 2 unit of work. So you know that B in 1 hour do 2 unit of work. Now the work left is only 1 unit. So 1 unit of work B would take half hour to finish. And fine. So the total work will be done in how many hours? Total work will be done in 9.5 hours. Because they are working alternatively. If they would be working together, then they would have finished the work in 24/5 hours. That is 4.8 hours. But they are not working together. They are working alternatively. Okay, so they are working alternatively. First hour A is doing, second hour B is doing. So in 2 hours, 5 unit of work will be done. Okay, similarly, so the 20 unit of work, because the total work is 24 units, so 20 unit of work is done on 8 hours. On 9th hour, who will work? A will work and do 3 unit of work. So then 1 unit of work is left, which is done by B in half an hour. Fine. Then you can see the next question, question number 8. So A and B can do a piece of work in 12 days. So A and B can do a piece of work in 12 days. And B and C can do the work in 15 days. B and C can do the work in 15 days. While A and C can do the same work in 20 days. Okay. Find the number of days which A alone can do the work. So same way, if you remember, before I did like this kind of problem, suppose P is there, P can do in 12, Q is there, which he can do in 15, and R is there, who can do the work in 20. Where assume P is equal to A plus B, and Q is equal to B plus C, and R is equal to A plus C. Now let the work as the LCM. So the LCM of them is 60 unit. So in one day, P do 5 unit, Q do 4 unit, and R do 3 unit. So when they are working together in one day, P plus Q plus R will do 12 unit of work together. So in 1 hour, in one day, P plus Q plus R do 12 unit of work. So the total work P plus Q plus R, total work is 60 units. So they will do in 5 days. Total work they will do in 5 days. Now you understand, you don't have P plus Q plus R. So P plus Q plus R is nothing but 2 times of A plus 2 times of B plus 2 times of C, means they will do in 5 days. Means A plus B plus C, they will do the work in 10 days. Now you know that A plus B plus C, if they do together, they'll complete the work in 10 days. And you know that B and C can do the work in 15 days. And you know that B and C can do the work in 15 days. So if I ask you, in how many days A alone can do the work? So this is a way of what way you need to do. So you need to understand that 1 by A in one day, 1 by A part in one day, 1 by B part in one day, 1 by C part. So A, B and C, when they do together, they'll complete the work in 10 days. Means in one day they are doing 1 by 10 part of work, while B and C in one day they are doing 1 by 15 part of work. So you subtract that equation, so you'll get 1 by A is equal to 1 by 10 minus 1 by 15. If you take the LCM, LCM is 30. So the A is doing the work. If A do work alone, then A would complete the work in 30 days. Now try the next question, everyone. Question number 9. Everyone try this question. Now A and B together can complete the work in 12 days. So A and B can together complete the work in 12 days. Okay, so which B and C can together complete in 16 days? Which B and C can complete in 16 days? Okay. So after A being working, so imagine in one day. So here in one day, suppose A can do 1 by A part of work. That understanding is important. In one day, the B can do 1 by B part of work. And in one day, the C can do 1 by C part of work. Fine. So A and B together can do a piece of work in 12 days and B and C in 16 days. After A being working for 5 days, so if after A working for 5 days, so in one day A is doing 1 by A part of work. So in 5 days, A would do 5 by A part of work and B for 7 days. So in one day, B do 1 by B part of work. So in 7 days, B would do 7 by B part of work. Okay. So then C take up and finish it alone in 13 days. So 13 days means, so in one day, C is doing 1 by C part of work. And so the total work C finish. This is the third equation. So now, so my two equation A plus B 12. I can say 1 by A plus 1 by B is 1 by 12. This is one equation. 1 by B plus 1 by C equal to 1 by 16. This is second equation. Now if I add them, so I can say 1 by A plus 2 by B plus 1 by C is 1 by 12 plus 1 by 16. LCM is 48. So that is 7 by 48. So now this is your third equation. And suppose this is your fourth equation. So this is given 5 by A plus 7 by B plus 13 by C. I think 13 by C is equal to fourth equation. So what I can do, I can cancel one variable. So I can cancel one variable. Let I cancel A. So if I want to cancel A, then I'll multiply this with 5. So if I multiply this with 5, I'll get 5 by A plus 10 by B plus 5 by C is equal to 35 by 48. This is my third equation. And my fourth equation, 5 by A plus 7 by B plus 13 by C equal to 1. This is my fourth equation. Subtract the equation 4 from equation 3. So we get 3 by B minus. So 3 by B minus, because you're subtracting. So minus 8 plus 5 is 30 minus 8 by C is 35 by 48 minus 1. So 48 minus 35 is 30. 48 minus 35 is 30. So I can say 8 by C minus 3 by B is equal to 13 by 48. This I can write as equation 5. And I know about B and C. What I know about B and C can do the work in 16 days. So means 1 by B plus 1 by C is 16. So I know that 1 by B plus 1 by C is 1 by 16. This is already I know. Okay, this is already I know. You can write this as equation 6. Now, which one to cancel? Let cancel B. So if you want to cancel B, you need to multiply it with 3. So multiply with 3, this get cancelled. So this would be 8 by C. What you are doing? Adding. 8 by C plus 3 by C is 13 by 48 plus 3 by 16. This is 48 LCM. 13 plus 16, 3 is 3 plus 3, 9. So this is 22 by 48. So you can write 11 by C is 22 by 48. So this is 24. So means then the C can do the work. C can complete the work in 24 days. Fine. Now see question number 10. Very easy, everyone. You can try, you can pause the video anytime and you can try the question. So here two friends are there and they can complete the work in 26 days. The skill of doing work are in ratio. So you know that efficiency is inversely proportional to time taken. Efficiency is inversely proportional to time taken. So the efficiency of A is to B is given 8 is to 5. This is their efficiency. So if you talk in the term of time taken, so the ratio of A is to B would be 5 is to 8. This would be ratio of their time taken. So let A can do the work in 5x days and B can do the work in 8x days if they work together. So let the work is 40x unit. So in one day A do 8 unit of work. In one day B do 3-5 unit of work. Together they do 30 unit of work in one day. Together they do 30 unit of work in one day. So if they're doing 30 unit of work in one day, 40x unit of work they will do in 40x by 30 days. So together they will do it 40x by 30 days. Now in this problem, this is given 20. This is given to you 26 days, so you can find the value of x. X is 13 into 26 by 40. So you can find the value of x. This is 13 by 20. So the value of x you get is 169 by 20 days. So when A and B are working together, they'll complete the work in 160 died by 20 days. Now they're asking you how much time the B take. B is 8x. How much time the B take? So this 8x they're asking you. So 8x is equal to 8 into 160 died by 20. So this is the time what the B take. That is 2 by 5. So this is 170. 2 is 340 minus 2. 340 minus 2 is 338 by 5. Okay. So 338 by 5. If you want to calculate, so this is 6 za, the 38, 7 za, 67, 3 by 5 days. This is the time what the B take to complete the work. Try question number 11, everyone. Now you can see for others that is question number 11. So if A here, so A, B, and C can do the work in 6, 8, and 12. So A can do the work in 6 days. So A can do the work in 6 days, B can do the work in 8 days, and C can do the work in 12 days. So define work as the LCM of 6, 8, and 12. So the work would be 24 unit. So if you talk, so the work would be, let the work as LCM. So the work would be 24 unit. So in one day A do 4 unit of work, in one day B do 3 unit of work, in one day C do 3 unit of work. So when A, B, and C are working together, they do 9 unit of work. So they are working in this ratio. So total work they will complete it 24 by 9 means 8 by 3 means 2 by 3 days. So if they are asking us when they will complete the work, they would complete the work in 2 by 3 days. So if they are working, so when they will complete the work, they will complete the work in 2 by 3 days. But here they are not asking you this. They're asking you when they're working, they got this money. So if you understand A, B, and C, they're working in the ratio 4 is to 3 is to 2. So how much would be the B share in this money? The B share in this money would be 3 by 9, means 1/3. This would be the B share. So the total money is 1350. So how much money the B get? B get 1/3 of 1350. So this B get 450 rupees. Now see the next question. Question number 2. So the question is like this, 8 men and 10 women are working together, can complete the work in 10 days. The work done by each woman is 4/5 of the work done by men. So one woman, the efficiency of one woman is equal to 4/5 of a man. So that is efficiency of 4 by 5th of a man means the efficiency of one woman is 80%. Okay. So here the total women are 10 women. So the 10 women are equal to how many men? So they are equal to how many men? They are equal to 8 men. 10 women are equal to 8 men. Okay. So in the problem it is given 8 men and 10 women. So other way I can say they are equal to 8 men plus 8 men, because 10 women are equal to 8 men in the term of efficiency. You have total 16 men. So if they're working together, they complete the work in 10 days. Means 16 men takes 10 days to complete the work. The total work, what is work? Work is equal to men into days. What is your total work? Work is equal to 16 into 10 men days. This is your total work. Okay, so now if in how many days 10 men can complete the same work. So now this is the total work. So this is your total work. Total work is 16 into 10 men days. So if 10 men do the work, so if 10 men will do the work, total work is 16 into 10 men days. So if 10 men will do the work, so how many days they will take to do the work? They will take 16 days to do the work. So the number of days what they will take to do the work will be 16. Very simple. Fine. Now you can see the next question. Question number 13 you can see. So A can do a work in 15 days and B alone can do it in 10 days. So what is the work? Define the work as the LCM. So in one day they do 5 unit of work. Total work they'll finish in 6 days. But here it is not the case. Here in this case, B work for 5 days and then leave. So means A and B means B work for 5 days. So in 5 days, how much work the B would do? So in one day B do 3 unit of work. So in 5 days B would do 15 unit of work. Okay. And the number of days, A is working from beginning to end. So suppose A work alone for X days, every day A do 2 unit of work. So together with B, so A and B together, they work for 5 days. And after that, suppose for X days, A worked alone. The question is that in how many days A alone can finish the remaining work? So they're asking you the X and the total work is 30. So you can write, this is 2x plus 10 is equal to 15. So 2x is equal to 5. X is equal to 2.5. So in how many days A alone can finish the remaining work? So this is 15, right? 1 minute. Huh? This is total work is 30. So 2x plus 10 is equal to 15. So 2x is equal to 5, so x is equal to 2.5. In how many days A alone can finish the remaining work? Finish the remaining work. So total time A is taking 7.5 days. So the remaining work A is finishing in 2.5 days. Other way also I can do this problem. Let me discuss the other way. That for 5 days A and B work together. So when in one day A and B together do how many unit of work? They do 5 unit of work. And 5 days they work together. For 5 days they work together. And then only A left, and A is doing the work, and then A left and A is doing the work. And suppose A work alone for X days to do the remaining work. Total work is 30. So 15, A can do 15, B can alone do in, B work for 5 days and then leave. So A alone. So this is fine. So this is then 25 plus 2x is equal to 30. So 2x is equal to 5. So x is equal to 2.5. So means they may be asking in like total time what the A takes to do the work, because A with B work for 5 days. and then we work for 2.5 days alone. So the total time what A takes, taken by A, total time what the A take, that is 5 day with B plus 2.5 day alone. This is the total time what the A takes to do the work. So the total, if they would be working together, they would have finished the work in 6 days only. Okay, so they see, understand, here if you see this problem, so they would have finished the work in 6 days. They would have finished the work in 6 days, but they work together for 5 days. So 100% of work they can finish in 6 days. So in 5 days, how much work they would have finished? They would have finished 5 by 6 part of work. 5 by 6 means they would have finished 83.33% of work. How much work left? 16.67% of work. So that 16.67% of work, who will do? A will do. Okay, A in 1 day do 1 by 15. So 1 by 15 is how much? 1 by 15 is 6.67%. 6.67% of work A can do in 1 day. So 16.67% of work A would do in how many days? So A would do in 2.5 days. So the total time what the A is taking to do the work, that is 7.5 days. Can finish the work. A alone can finish the work. This should be the problem. Now, you can see the next problem. Question number 14. You can see this question number 14. So A supplies 20 men who can work for 8 hours per day for 6 days. So you know the formula, work is equal to men into days. And you can write the same thing. Work is equal to men into day. So days means hour per day into total days. All means same thing only. So that gives you the work is equal to men into hour. So it doesn't matter here. Here the units and all doesn't matter. So day means time. Men means individual. So here A supplies 20 men who can work 8 hours a day for 6 days. So this is 980 hours. Okay, and then man hour, whatever. B supplies 15 men who can work 9 hours a day for 7 days. So 63 means 945. And C supplies 10 men working 6 hours a day for 8 days. So this is 480 hours. This is 8 to the 16. This is 960 hours. Well, it's 960. Okay. Now, if you see the ratio in which they are working, they are working in this ratio 960 is to 945 is to 480. So you can see the ratio of A is to B is to C. So the ratio is, if I divide by 5, so I'll get 190. 192 is to 189 is to 96. I can see the ratio. I can see the ratio. So they're working in this ratio. So in this problem, A supplies 20 men who works for 8 hours per day for 6 days. B supplies 15 men who works 9 hours per day for 7 days. And C supplies 10 men working. So if 936 rupees is paid for all the labor, what is the C share? So what is the C's share in this? So now okay, leave it. So if I talk about A plus B plus C, the sum what you're getting is how much? 192 plus 189 and 96. So this is 1117. Then this is how much? 9 threes are 27. Then 2 carry 477. So they're working in that ratio. So what should be the C share? So if you see A is equal to 192x, B is equal to 189x, and C is equal to 96x. So the total is 477x. So how much the money they are getting? They are getting 636 rupees. They are asking you the C share. The C share would be 96 by 477 into 636. So this will go in which table? So 477, 14, 18. Okay, this will go by 3. So this is 1za, 17. 17 means 5za, 159. This is 212. And then this is 32. Then this is 53. Then in three table when you get two, so you get 2 4za. 53 4za 12, 1 carry. This is 4za. What is C share? The C share would be 128. Now you can see the next question. Question number 15. A and B can do a piece of work in 45 and 40 days respectively. They begin to do the work together, but A left after some days and B completed the remaining work. So you can see this question. Question number 15. So here A and B can do a piece of work. A can do a piece of work in 45 days. B can do a piece of work in 40 days. They begin to do the work. So what is the LCM? So the LCM would be 5 into 8 into 9. 72 5s are 360. So the length of work is 360 units. So how much work A is doing? So 9 into 8 into 5 divided by 9 into 5 means 8za, 45 8za, 94za, yeah, 8 units. So in one day, how much work A do? 8 units. Then this in one day, this is how much work B do? 9 units. So when they're working together in one day, A and B together do how many units of work? 17 units. And total work they will finish in 360 by 17 days. Okay, so they begin to do the work, but A left after some days and B completed the remaining work in 23 days. So A left after some days, suppose A left after X days. So means how much work then A would have done in X days? 8X work. And the B in one day do 9 units of work and B completed the remaining work in 23 days. So B worked for how many days? So 23 plus X days. And so for X days, A and B worked together and then remaining work B did alone for 23 days. And they completed the total work, that is 360 units. 8x is equal to 23 9 3 27, 2 carry 207 plus 9x is equal to 360. 17x is equal to 200. 360 minus 200 is 160. 160 minus 7, 153. X is equal to 9 days. So for 9 days, A and B work together. So the number of days after which A left the work is 9 days. So question number 16. A man is paid 5 rupees per hour for the regular working hour and 8 hours per hour, 8 rupees per hour for overtime. Okay, and a regular working day has 7 hours. So for regular hour he is getting 5 rupees. So in one day, how much he was earning? In one day he was earning 40 rupees. Okay. So if you don't do any extra work, and regular week has 5 working days. So in 1 week, how much is to work? In one day, in 1 week, five working days. One day 40 rupees. So in 1 week is to earn 200 rupees. So if he earns 920 rupees in 4 weeks, so in 4 weeks he will earn how much? 204 is 800 rupees. And if you do normal work, he'll earn 800 rupees. But he's earning 920 rupees. Means extra 120 rupees must be from extra hour, and 120 rupees is earning extra. Okay, so it means that 120 rupees definitely from the overtime. And suppose for X hour he do overtime, because for 1 hour of overtime is getting 8 rupees. So the X is equal to how much? 15. So for 15 hours he did overtime. So the total number of hour he worked. The total number of hour he worked means total number of hour how much he worked. Total number of hour he worked is 4 week plus 15 hours. And so 4 week, so they're given 4 week. So the total hour he worked is 4 week plus 15 hours. So they're asking per hour. So in 1 week, so in a day, in 1 day 5 hours, total 5 days. Okay, so total hour is how much? So in 1 day 5 hours, and in a week you have 5 working days. In a 1 day, sorry, 1 day how much is a working hour? 1 day 8 hours is a working hour. So 8 hours is 1 day, and total 5 days in a week, and the total 4 week total, and then plus 15 he did extra hour. So means total he worked is 5 4 is 20 20 into 8 160. 160 plus 15. So he worked total 175 hours. Now see the next question. Now see the next question. Ram finishes the work in 7 days. So Ram finishes the work in 7 days. Okay, so Ram finishes the work in 7 days, and Rahim finishes the same work in 8 days. And Rahim finishes the same work in 8 days, and Robert finishes the same work, and Robert, 1 minute. So when you see the work, Ram is finishing this work in 7 days. So Ram is finishing the work in 7 days. Rahim can do the same work in 8 days. And Robert can do the same work in 6 days. they take turns to finish the work. Ram worked on first day, Rahim worked on second day, Robert worked on third day, like that. So again, define the work as the LCM. Again, define the work as the LCM. So what is the LCM of 7, 8 and 6? So LCM of 7, 8 and 6 will be 7 into 8 into 6 because they're four prime number. So 7 into 8 into 6, the LCM will be 6 into 8 into 7. So if you go by 2, this is 3, 4, 7. Now no number will it go. So this is 24 into 7. 24 into 7, I think, is 168. So this is 24 into 7 is 168. Let the work is 160 unit. So means in so how much Ram is doing? Pooja 24 unit one day. How much Rahim is doing? 21 unit. Robert, that is Pooja 28 unit. Okay, 48 means, yeah. So if they are working together, they will be working 1373 unit in one day. The total work they would have finished in 168 by 73 days. But here they are not working together, they are working alternatively. So in 3 days, how much work they finished? 73 unit. If I do Pooja into 2, so I'll get 146. So in 6 days, how much work get over? 146 unit. Now you see 168 is close to 146. So now I'll not go, because in 9 days it would be 73 3/3, that would be 219, but the total work is 168. So on 7th day, who will work? Ram will work. On 7th day, who will work? Ram will work. And in one day, Ram do 24 unit. So how much work get over? 146 plus 24, 170 unit. Okay. So this means 7th day the work will get over. Before 7th day, is from 6 to 7 days the work get over. Because you understand, right? Because after 6 days 146 was over, 146 unit was over, or then on 7th day the Ram can do 24 unit. So 146 plus 24 is 170, but the work is 168. So means Ram will finish the work on 7th day. Now you can see the question. Next question. A contractor undertook to do the work in 9 days. He employed certain number of labor. Suppose total labor were A. So the total work is equal to 9A. So 9 day and A labor. So the work was 9A. But 6 of them were absent from beginning. So only A minus 6 laborer work. And because of which the work got finished in 15 days. Okay. So you just need to solve it. You can write 3A is equal to 5A minus 30. So A is equal to 15. So this 9 and 15 both will go by 3. So 3A, so that is 5A minus 5 into 6, 30. So 2A is equal to 30. So A is equal to 15. Now see this. Question number 19. So pipe A and B can fill that tank in 20 and 30 hours. Well, C can empty the full tank in 40 hours. So A 20 hour, B 30 hour, and C 40 hours. So A and B can fill the tank while C is removing the water from the tank. So total LCM would be 120, 60 only the LCM. So total LCM would be 160 unit. This would do 6 unit of work. This 4 unit of work, this minus 3 unit of work, because C is removing. So So 7 units of work is done in 1 hour. So the total work get over in 120 by 7. So if all, so how much time you will take to full the task? That is 120 by 7. 120 by 7 is 1 za 50. 50 means 7 za 17, 1 by 7 hour. 17, 7 za is anyways 119. Next question, question number 20. Two pipe A and B can each fill in 14, 60 minutes. While there's an outlet C, if all of them are open, then the tank get filled in 30 minutes. How much time the C alone will be the tank? So A in 40, A in 50, B in 60, okay, both are filling, and C removing. C, suppose C minute, it can remove. So what is the LCM of 40, 60 and C? That would be 12. 12 will go to 40 and 60. Let the work is 120C. Let the work is 120C. So let the work is 120C unit. So in 1 hour or in 1 minute, how much A would do? That would be 3C. And 4, 3 is 12. B, 2C. And C is removing. So A and B, they are doing constructive work. And C is doing a destructive work, and the tank get filled. Means the construction is more than destruction. The construction is more powerful than destruction. So C will remove how much? That would be minus 120. Yeah. So means in 1 minute, if they're working together, how much part they get filled? That is 5C minus 120. This much get filled in 1 minute. And the total will get filled in 30 minutes. Total will get filled in 30 minutes. So 30 into 5C minus 120. And that means that is equal to total work. Total work is 120C. So I can write 5C minus 120 is equal to 4C. So C is equal to 120 minute. 120 minute in hour is equal to 2 hours. Then three tape A, B, C together can fill in 6 hours. After working 2 hours, C is closed. So A, B and C, A plus B plus C, they can fill 100% in 6 hours. Okay, so they work for 2 hours. So how much work they would have done in 2 hours? That is 1/3 of the work and 1/3 of work. And means 33.33%. How much work left? The work left is 2/3. So then C is closed. Achha. And then tank is filled in eight hour mode. Means to do 2/3 of the work, A and B took how many hours? 8 hours. Okay, so the total work A plus B will do in how many hours? They will do in 12 hours. So that is 3/2 of 8. By 2 of 8, that means 12 hours. So the A and B together will take 12 hours to do the work. Okay, they're asking about C. If I ask about C, so now you know that A plus B plus C is 6 hours, and you know that A plus B means 12 hours. So definitely C would be 12 hours. Simple. If you want explanation, we can do calculation on that part. A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C is 6 hours. And 1 by A plus 1 by B is 12 hours. So you subtract the second equation from the first equation, you get 1 by C equal to 1 by 6 minus 1 by 2. You will get 1 by 2. C can do in how many hours? 12 hours. Fine. Now to try this question number 22. It came in 2011 UPSC exam. Now see question number 22. A conveyor belt delivers baggage at the rate of 3 tons in 5 minutes. Again, conveyor belt can deliver at the rate of 1 ton in 2 minutes. So first conveyor belt 3 ton in 5 minutes. The first conveyor ton is 5 by 3 minute. 1 ton, so 1 ton 5 by 3 minute. Second conveyor belt 1 ton in 2 minute. So you can take LCM. What is LCM of 5 by 3 and 2? So the LCM of 5 by 3 and 2, so that would be the LCM of 5 and 2 divided by the HCF of 1 and 3. So that would be equal to 10. I believe you know LCM of fraction is equal to LCM of numerator divided by HCF of denominator. So this would be let the work is equal to 10 units. So let the work is 10 units. So in 1 minute, how much work the A do? That is 6 units of work. In 1 minute, how much work the B do? That is 5 units of work. Together, they do 3 units of work in 1 minute. 3 unit of work in 1 minute. So the total work will be done in 10 by 11 minutes. Okay, so how much time will it take for them to get 33 tons of baggage? So 1 ton of baggage together when they are working. So they are doing in 10 by 11 minutes. So 33 ton of baggage they will do in how many minutes? That would be 30 minutes. 1 ton in 10 by 11. So 33 ton is 33 into 10 by 11 means 30 minutes. Now see the next question. Next question, a leak in the bottom of tank can empty the tank in 4-6 hours. Inlet pipe fill the water at the rate of 4 liter per minute. And when the tank is full, the inlet is open and due to that, the leak get empty in 8 hours. So you find the capacity of the tank. So without inlet, the work is done in 12 hours. Because of inlet, the work is getting over in 8 hours. So actually how much contribution inlet is doing, you understand only outlet. If you have only outlet, the work is getting over in 12 hours. 12 hours means 1 by 12 part in 1 hour means 8.33% of work was happening. Okay, every hour. Handwriting is not good. So if you have only inlet working, if you have only outlet pipe working, so the total you take 8 hours to empty. Okay. Now in 1 hour, how much the outlet pipe is working? Outlet pipe is working 1 by 8 part or 12.5% of work. 1 by 8 is 12.5% of work. Why you don't know this? Yeah. So that is 6 hours, the empty in 6 hours. So that it can do in 6 hours. So in 1 hour, the outlet pipe remove how much? Remove 1 by 6 part. 1 by 6 part means 16.67 part. Okay, because of inlet, so when outlet and inlet, when both are working, so then the total time it is taking is 8 hours. Total time it is taking in 8 hours means 1 hour. How much the water is getting removed? 1 by 8 part. 1 by 8 part means 12.5%. So you can understand that only outlet, the work was 16.67%. That much water was going out. This much percentage of water was going out. So when when you have outlet minus inlet, because inlet will create problem. So because inlet will fill water, so the now the total work happening is 12.5%. So with this you can find the percentage of inlet. What is the percentage of work done by inlet pipe? That is 16.67% minus 12.5%. That is how much? This is 4.17%. 4.17% is nothing but 1 by 24. So those who have knowledge about percentage, they can tell. It means the inlet pipe takes 24 hours. So it means inlet pipe alone can fill the water in 24 hours if we're working alone, because you understand here the outlet is dominating. No, inlet is doing the work in 24 hours while outlet is removing the water in 6 hours. You understand? No, in 1 hour inlet pipe is just doing 4.17% of work. But in 1 hour, the outlet pipe is doing 16.67% of work. So you can easily understand the outlet pipe is dominating here. Okay. So if only inlet pipe is working, then inlet pipe would have done the work in 24 hours. Okay. Now they have given the capacity, they have given the speed of inlet pipe, that the speed of inlet pipe is 4 liter water in 1 minute. So inlet pipe, speed of inlet pipe is 4 liter water in 1 minute. So you can understand inlet pipe in 1 minute is putting 4 liter water. So in 1 minute it is putting 4 liter water. So you can say in 60 minutes it will put 240 liter of water. So means 1 hour it is putting 240 liter of water. So now the inlet pipe would take 24 hours to do the work. So in 24 hours the inlet pipe would take 5760 liter of water. 24 square, that so the capacity of the tank is 5760 liter. This is the capacity of the tank. This is the one way of solving the problem. I don't know how many of you would like this way. So in order to do it like this way, you should be good with the concept on percentage. Otherwise you can do traditional method and all. You can apply traditional method. So if you talk about inlet pipe, so the inlet pipe do 4 liter of water in 1 minute. So you can say in 60 minutes it will fill 240 liter water. So let the capacity of the tank is x liter. So if you talk about inlet pipe is putting 240 liter in 1 hour. So the inlet pipe would fill the complete tank. Inlet pipe would fill the complete tank, means x liter, in how many hours? That would be x by 240 hours. So if you talk about inlet pipe will fill the complete water in x by 240 hours. If you see outlet pipe alone is removing all the water in 6 hours, and inlet pipe alone putting water in x by 240 hours. So if they work together, so when the work will get over, the outlet is removing, inlet is putting. So and the total water get removed in 8 hours. So I'm putting a plus sign for water being out and minus sign for water coming in, because that is a net output. So what is LCM of 6 and x by 240? So LCM would be 6x. So let the total work is 6x unit. You understand, no? Because LCM of fraction is LCM of numerator divided by HCF of denominator. So in 1 hour, how much water it will remove? It will remove X unit of water. In 1 hour, how much water it will put? That would be 6X by X by 240 means minus 1440 unit. 144. So when in 1 hour, when they're working together, so they are removing X by 1440 unit of water. And the total water will get removed in 8 hours. 8 into X minus 1440 unit. And that is equal to the total work. Total work is 6x. So you can write 8 into x minus 1440 equal to 6x. So you can write 4 into x minus 1440 is equal to 3x. So I can write 4x minus 144 is 5760 equal to 3x. I can write X is equal to 5760 liter, which is the capacity of the container. Now see question number 24, everyone. 50 men or 80 women can finish the work in 50 days. A contractor deploys 40 men and 48 women to do the work, but after every 10 days, 5 men and 8 women are removed from the work till the work get completed. Then the work are completed in how many days? So this came in UPSC exam. I don't remember which year it came. Just copy this question. Okay, just see this question, everyone. Try to do from your end. Now you can see this, 50 men or 80 women can finish the work in 50 days. So if you define the work in the term of men, if you define the work in the term of men, then the work is 50 into 50 men day. And if you define the work in the term of women, you define the work in the term of women, then the work is 80 into 50 women day. This way you can define the work. Okay, work is equal to men into days. Okay, the next thing is that a contractor deploys 40 men and 48 women to do the work. So you know that if I talk in the term of efficiency, then 50 men is equal to 80 women. So I can say that 5 men is equal to 8 women, correct? So 80 women is equal to 50 men, you know that. Okay, so 48 women will be equal to how many men? 8 sixa, so that is equal to 30 men. So now this is the total work in the term of men. Now 40 men and 48 women. So now you know that So if I talk about 40 men plus 48 women, so I can say 40 men plus, in place of 48, I can write 30. So total 70 men are there. So if I talk in that way, so because I know 5 men is equal to 8 women, so 48 women equal to 30 men. In place of 48 women, I can write 30 men. So the total 70 men, I can say. Because in order to solve the question, I need to use only one variable. You can say contractor deploys. So 40 men and 48 women for this work. But after every duration of 10 days, 5 men and 8 women are removed. Okay, so now you have 70 men. And they work for 10 days. So the work they do is 700 men day. So the total work they would have done is 700 men day. And the work done. Total work is how much? 2500. If you talk in the term of men. So how much work left? That is 2500 minus 700. 16. 16 plus 7. 25. No? 25 minus 7, that is 1800. 1800 men day work is left. Okay. Then what is happening? So they work for 10 days. So then after the duration 10 days, 5 men and 8 women. So 8 women is equal to 5 men. Na? 8 women is equal to 5 men. You can see 8 women is equal to 5 men. It means 5 men plus 5 men. Total 10 men are removed. So now you have 60 men. Every time 10 men are removed. So they work for 10 days. So 600 men day work done. Total is 2500. If you do 600, how much work left? That is 1200 men day. Then again 10 men get removed. So 50 men and they work for 10 days. So 500 men day. It's like in AP. You understand? It is in AP and every time the value is decreasing. So 500. Men day, so now there's 700 men day work left and a 2500. You can see the total work done. Total, if you see the work done, total work is 700. Then here 600, 700 plus 600, 1300. 1300 plus 500, 1800. And then again, after that, 40 men and they work for 10 days. So total 400 men day work done. Total is 2500. So 18 plus 4, 2200. And the work left is 300. Then after that, then you have 30 men, 10 men left. Into 10 days they'll work. They'll do 300 men day. Total work is 2500. And so they'll do 2500. And now work left is 0. So means how many days they took? So the total days they took is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So the total days they took to complete the work is 50 days. This came in UPSC exam. I don't know the year. So this is very important question. So any moment of time, if you got any difficulty, you can pause the video and you can watch that. Now the next question. So the next question is Rohit, Harish and Sanjeev are three typists who are working simultaneously and they can type 216 page in 4 hours. So in 1 hour, Rohit plus Harish plus Sanjeev, they are doing how many page? So they are doing 54 page. So in 1 hour they are doing 54 page. Okay. Now in 1 hour Sanjeev can type as many page more than Harish as Harish can type more than Rohit. So they are in AP, you can understand. So together, so suppose in 1 hour Rohit type R page, Harish type H page, Sanjeev type S page. So you can understand Sanjeev can type as many page more than Harish. Sanjeev can type as many page more than Harish is more than Rohit. You can understand this. So Sanjeev plus Rohit is equal to 2 times of Harish. So you can understand Harish is equal to S plus R by 2. So means your, which is bigger? S is bigger than H and H is bigger than R. You need to understand S, H and R, they all are in EP. So their difference is same. So the smaller term is R. So you can say R, then H, then S. They are in EP with common difference. Whenever we say EP, so the difference is same, common difference. Suppose R in R, R page per hour. So H would be R plus, so R plus D or R minus D, anything. Let it be. So R plus D. So S would be R plus 2D. They are in AP. So what is written? During the period of 5 hours, Sanjeev can type as many pages as Rohit in 7 hours. So the number of work that Sanjeev can do in 5 hours, that Rohit can do in 7 hours. So Sanjeev, I can write R plus 2D. This is equal to 7R. So 5R plus 10D. Is equal to 7R. So R is equal to 5D. I can write like this. So 2R is equal to 10D. R is equal to 5D. So R is equal to 5D. Then this is 6D, this is 7D. So R is equal to 5D and H is 6D and S is 7D. So they all are in EP. And they're given, this is given to you 54 page. The total is 54. The total is 11, 18. 18D is 54 page. This is given to you. So B is equal to 3 page. So what they're asking you, how many page in each of them in 1 hour. So each of them, so you can find each of them. So R is 15 page and H is 18 page and Sanjeev is 21 page. So these many page, 15, 18 and 21, these many page they type per hour. Okay. This is the answer. Now you can see this question. This came in 2017 UPSC. So P worked thrice as fast as Q. So P work thrice as fast as Q. So if P can do the work in P day, then Q can do the same work in 3P day. So if they work together, let the work is 3P unit. So in one day P do 3 unit of work. In one day the Q do 1 unit of work. Together they do 4 unit of work. So in one day, in one day they do 4 unit of work. So total work P plus Q will finish in 3P by 4 days. Days or hour, whatever. I don't know. So 3P by 4. Total work P and Q would finish in 3P by 4 days. So if P and Q and R, so then so whereas P and Q together can work 4 times as fast as R. It is written next line. That next line is P and Q is 4 times faster than R. If P and Q is 4 times faster than R, so here P and Q can do the work in 3P by 4 days. It means R will complete the work in 4 times of 3P by 4 days. It means R will take 3P days to complete the work. And now Now, if they work together, in what ratio they work? If they work together, in what ratio they work? So P is working the work in P days. Q is doing the work in 3P days. And R is doing the same work in again in 3P days. So if you take the LCM would be let the work is 3P units. So he is doing 3 unit of work. He is doing 1 unit of work. R is doing 1 unit of work. So in what ratio they are working? P is to Q is to R. They are working in the ratio 3 is to 1 is to 1. Now you can see the next question. Ram and Syam work on a job for 4 days and complete 60% of work. So 60% is 3/5 part of work. Ram and Syam did in 4 days. So Ram and Syam can do the total work in 5/3 × 4, means 20/3 days. So the Ram and Syam can do total work in 20/3 days. While Ram take leave and Syam work for 8 more days to complete the work. So you understand 60% of the work was done only. So for 40% of work, 40% means 2/5 part of work, Syam takes 8 days. So the, for the total work, the Syam would take 20 days. Ram and Syam together, they are completing the work in 20/3 days. While for finishing the 40% of work, Syam takes 8 days. While for finishing the 40% of work, because 60% is done, Syam takes 8 days. So means 100% of work, Syam will finish in how many days? That is 100/40 × 8. So that is 20 days. And where Ram and Syam, when they're working together, they're completing the work in 20/3 days. While Ram and Syam, when they're working together, they're completing the work in 20/3 days. While Syam alone can complete the work in 20 days. With this, you can say 1/r + 1/s is 3/20. 1/s is 1/20. You can find the value of 1/r. So what is the value of r? So 1/r is 3/20 − 1/20. That is 1/10. So in how many days the Ram alone can do the work? If the Ram alone work, that is 10 days. This came in UPSC 2016. Okay, now see the next question. W can do, this came in UPSC again 2016. W can do 25% of work in 10 days. So 25% of work W can do in 30 days. So means total work W can do in 120 days. And 25% is 1/4. So doing 1/4, you taking 30 days. So the total work will do 4 × 30, means to 120 days. And X can, so W completing the work in 120 days. And X do 1/4. This is 1/4. Okay, this is 1/4. So X do 1/4 of the work in 40 days. 1/4 of work in 40 days. So the total work in 40 days. Okay, then Y do 40% of work in 40 days. So 40% of work in 40 days. So 100% of work in 100 days. And so the X in 100 days, you understand 40% is 2/5. We're doing 2/5 part of work is taking 40 days. 100 part of work, 100% of work, he'll do in how many days? That is 100 days. Now Z do 1/3 of the work in 13 days. So the total work Z will take 39 days. So 1/3 mean 33.33%. 1/3 of the work in 13 days. So the total work in 39 days. So who will complete the work first? Z will complete the work. So this much. So around 30 questions I discussed, and more primarily, these were the questions which came in past UPSC CSET exam. So I tried to cover more or less all the questions which came in past papers for UPSC exam, and those questions which are important for your exam preparation. So I hope you enjoyed this class. With that intention, I like to say thank you to all of you. If you like the class, please click on the like button and please subscribe to my channel if you have not subscribed. Thank you, everyone. God bless you. Bye.